May I now request Chief of the Naval Staff, Admiral Zafar Mahmood Abbasi, Nishan-e-Imtiaz Military, to kindly address the parade.
Nahmadu wa nasalli ala rasulihil kareem amma baad auz billahi minash shaitanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim rabbish rahli sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli sadaqallahul azim. Admiral Muhammad Amjad Khan Niazi, CNS designate, former Chiefs of Naval Staff, Flag Officers, Officers, CPS Sailors, Navy Civilians, Ladies and Gentlemen, Assalamu Alaikum wa Rahmatullahi wa Barakatuhu. May Allah's peace, blessing and mercy be on all of us. To begin with, I profoundly thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his countless blessings and mercy that enabled me to command Pakistan Navy with honesty, justice, honor and dignity. I also thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting me the privilege and guiding me to lead such a fine service. Here I also congratulate Admiral Muhammad Amjad Khan Niazi for having been appointed to this prestigious and onerous post. After assuming command, I envisioned to transform the Navy into a highly capable force with special emphasis on optimum battle preparedness and professional competence, unwavering faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the national cause, and Pakistan Navy's contribution towards maritime economy. In pursuance of this refined PN vision, I identified three pillars, that is combat readiness, jump-starting the maritime economy, and reinforcing the ideological domain. Alhamdulillah, with the untiring efforts of the finest officers and men who worked as a team, Pakistan Navy has progressed as envisioned. Ladies and gentlemen, during the last 3 years, we have witnessed a volatile geopolitical landscape, heightened tension in the region, near conflict with our eastern neighbor driven by Hindutva ideology, and a complex internal security situation. To meet these challenges, I had accorded top priority to combat readiness and offensive capability of the Navy. Pakistan Navy's war plans were reviewed, practiced, and our employment and development strategies were aligned with the evolving threats and challenges. On the employment side, Pakistan's geographical position was leveraged to accrue operational advantage. This entailed reorganizing destroyer and patrol craft squadrons into surface task groups 1, 2, and 3 and stationing them permanently at Gwadar, Urmara, and Karachi respectively, and activation of aviation bases along the west coast equipped for day and night operations. Creeks area defense plan was revised with an offensive bias through integrated strike groups comprising Marines and SSG elements. On the development side, Pakistan Navy had historically been operating with 8 to 9 major surface ships, which constrained our regional footprint and influence. To redress this, fleet size of 50 plus ships, including 20 major ships, was envisioned. To this end, 4 Chinese type 054 Alpha frigates will join the fleet between 2021 and 2023. 4 Turkish Milgem class ships will be inducted between 2023 and 2025. Under the Milgem project, complete design know-how will be transferred to Pakistan Navy. Thus, the 5th ship presently under design phase, will inshallah be Pakistan's first Jinnah-class frigate, designed and built in Pakistan. Of the 2 into 2,300-ton corvettes, the lead ship PNS Yarmouk has been inducted, while the second ship, Tabuk, will join Pakistan Navy fleet by November this year. As a follow-up, 6 additional ships with larger tonnage are being contracted. Furthermore, 20 locally designed and built gunboats will be inducted by 2025. Fleet tanker PNS Marvin and survey vessel Bahar Massa were inducted in October 18 and November 19, respectively, and locally designed and built FACM 4 PNS Habith will inshallah be commissioned by the end of 2020. Angor-class submarine project in collaboration with China is progressing well, with 4 submarines being built in China and 4 in Pakistan to be delivered in the next few years. Under this project, submarine design and construction capability is being acquired to make Pakistan from a submarine operating navy to a submarine builder's navy. For enabling smooth transition towards Chinese origin submarines, 1-into-1 class submarine is being acquired from PLA Navy as a training platform on greatest basis. Naval Air Arm vision was promulgated in November 2017. 2 PN-ATR aircraft after upgradation in Germany have rejoined the fleet, while 3rd ATR currently being upgraded will rejoin next year. In addition, 10 jet long-range maritime patrol aircraft as replacement of P-3C aircraft will inshallah be inducted. In this regard, to lower cost, commercial jet aircraft has been selected, which will be retrofitted with avionics suit on ATR model. The contract for first jet aircraft has been signed. Moreover, contract for combat unmanned air vehicles with long-range, high-endurance and satellite link capability has also been signed. In the present day asymmetric threat environment, Special Operations Forces have a leading role in our security strategy. Pakistan Marines Vision 2030, approved in March 18, envisions Pakistan Marines to be a division plus size force by 2030. Marines Training Center has been shifted from Karachi to Gwadar. Similarly, SSGN Vision 2023, formulated in August 18, envisions SSGN to be a brigade-sized force by 2023. In the offensive missile technology, Pakistan Navy has made major strides with the local development of ship and submarine-launched Harba anti-ship and land attack missile system. In the hypersonic domain, ship-based long-range anti-ship and land attack PE-282 ballistic missile is under development. To enhance Pakistan Navy's operational flexibility along our coast, a major naval base for surface ships is being developed at Gwadar, while Ormara Yard will house repair and rebuild facilities for Angor-class submarines. PNS Siddiq at Turbat is now a full-fledged naval air station of Pakistan Navy LRMPs. While continuing our participation in Combined Task Forces 150 and 151, Pakistan Navy initiated regional maritime security patrols in 2018 in the Indian Ocean region to protect our maritime interests and fulfill international obligations. Aman 19 witnessed participation of 46 countries, largest so far in any Aman exercise. Pakistan Navy ships also undertook first ever overseas deployment around the African continent and established medical camps in various countries. PNS Aslat participated in Russian Navy's Victory Day parade at St. Petersburg in August 18, first ever by a PN ship. Ladies and gentlemen, to improve efficiency, various organizational initiatives were undertaken. In naval headquarters, a middle tier comprising 3 star flag officers as chiefs of staff heading operations, personnel and logistic wings was introduced between CNS and functionally grouped branches. A dedicated Naval Research and Development Institute co-located with Pakistan Navy Engineering College was established in 2019 to utilize the potential of uniformed PhD scholars and research students to develop niche technologies and to resolve intricate technical issues faced by Pakistan Navy. NRDI is engaged in design projects of Jinnah class frigate and Hangur class submarines. Within a short period, NRDI has successfully completed or is working on numerous high-tech projects such as UAV jammers, video telemetry system for PN aircraft, video analytics for security systems, laser-based directed energy weapons, sound underwater surveillance systems along the coast, mine warfare data center, unmanned underwater vehicles, unmanned combat air vehicles, high-speed target drones, etc. A naval officer was appointed as head of MES Navy for the first time ever in July 2018, and lateral entry civil engineers are being gradually inducted to fully man MES with Pakistan Navy officers. This has resulted in a number of improvements, including reduction in cost, efficient contracting, etc. Ladies and gentlemen, to create a vibrant maritime culture and channelize efforts to exploit Pakistan's blue economy, the second pillar of my vision was jump-starting the country's maritime sector. On PN's pursuance, reforms in public sector organization of maritime affairs have been initiated. To spur the interest of business community in tapping the blue economy, I interacted with various chambers of commerce and maritime industry across the country, which has resulted in various projects being pursued as joint ventures through Beria Foundation. Maritime Works Organization was created in October 18 under Beria Foundation for the development of coastal infrastructure and offshore marine projects. Beria Foundation has also established Pakistan's first ever Ships Classification Society, named as Beria Classification Society, in May 19. It is in the process of developing national and international partnerships. During my visit to China in April 2018, I met head of the China Geological Survey and requested for offshore hydrocarbon resource survey of Pakistan's exclusive economic zone. Consequently, two expeditions have been undertaken by CGS ships on gratis basis. This is for the first time ever in our history that whole of Pakistan's EEZ has been surveyed systematically for oil and gas resources. I am happy to inform that preliminary results of these surveys are promising, which place Pakistan amongst top nations with respect to natural gas resource potential. To be exact, it is fourth in the world ranking. The third joint expedition with CGS is planned next year and would involve advanced research work with respect to identification of prospective test drilling locations. In the field of maritime education, new degree programs in maritime disciplines have been introduced at Berry University and Pakistan Navy Engineering College. Pakistan's only maritime science and technology park is also being built at Karachi under the auspices of Beria University. Ladies and gentlemen, third pillar of my vision focused on reinvigorating the ideological domain to develop a highly motivated human resource imbued with strong faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A systematic approach was adopted to provide correct perspective in the light of Muttafaqa alayh Islamic teachings based on Quran and Sunnah. Pakistan Navy's motto based on Surah Ali Imran, verse number 173, Hasbullahu ni'mal wakeel, was promulgated in PN to repose absolute trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala under all situations and adversities. MRI setup was strengthened with induction of religious and motivation officers who have been appointed at headquarters, all major PN ships, establishments and mosques. And these officers have degrees from authentic religious institutions as well as a master's degree in any of the worldly subjects. A panel of Jayyid ulama representing all schools of thought have been constituted to render advice on religious matters. Teaching of Quranic Arabic language has been made compulsory at Pakistan Navy and Berea Foundation education institutions. All PN benevolent and rehabilitation schemes have been made Sharia compliant, and all non-public funds have been shifted to Sharia compliant banking. Ladies and gentlemen, welfare of Pakistan Navy personnel has always remained close to my heart. To overcome the perennial shortage of service accommodation, a 6-year plan was approved in January 2018 to build more than 6,000 houses for officers and men, of which over 3,000 houses are either completed or under construction. With this, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all PN personnel will get service accommodation as per their entitlement by the year 2025. While the waiting period of Navy housing scheme for officers has been reduced from LPR plus 50 months to within LPR, Pakistan Navy welfare housing scheme for CPO sailors has been reinvigorated, whereby all CPO sailors in PN, like the officers, have become members of the scheme. Under this scheme, all CPOs and POs on retirement will get house, whereas leadings and below on retirement will get their deposited amount with Sharia compliant profit. In healthcare, PNS Shifa is being completely rebuilt as per the master plan. A new 500 bed building is under construction for PNS Hafiz, and PNS Dharmanja has been expanded. Construction of hospitals at Khalid Asari, Yunusabad, Bin Qasim and Turbat has commenced. Pakistan Navy electronic healthcare system has been introduced at all PN hospitals. In the field of education, various new projects were initiated, which include launching of Berea University Medical and Dental College at Naval Anchorage, Islamabad, School of Maritime Sciences at Berea University, Karachi, and new campus of Berea University at Lahore. For uniformity, one schooling system for the children of officers and CPO sailors has been introduced in PN, whereby all PN model schools are being upgraded to the standard of Berea colleges. Ladies and gentlemen, all this wouldn't have been possible without the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unflinching support extended by the principal staff officers and staff at Naval Headquarters, and the field commands, and indeed all the valiant officers, CPO sailors, and Navy civilians of Pakistan Navy. It was indeed a singular honor to have commanded the finest body of men and women, and I am thankful to each one of them for contributing in the development and progress of Navy. I am now handing over command of the Navy to Admiral Muhammad Amjad Khan Niazi. The Admiral has a distinguished career studded with notable achievements. He sets high standards, and I am confident he would continue to lead the Navy to newer heights. I wish him the best of luck and a successful tenure in office. In the end, I would also like to thank the government for having reposed their trust in me. I also thank Ministry of Defense, Joint Staff Headquarters, and Sister Services for rendering all-out support to Pakistan Navy. I find myself short of words to express my gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his countless blessings throughout my life. As I say farewell to arms, I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable Pakistan Navy to continue to gain strength and achieve the zenith of excellence. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be our guide and protector. Pakistan Navy, Zindabad, Pakistan, Paindabad.